Welcome to Mudding with Beegs, episode 16. Today we're going to go to Binghamton, I never heard of this, New York, circa 1905, Kilmer Building, Chenago Street, Binghamton. I ain't never heard of that. I've been all over the United States, I ain't never heard of that, and I certainly ain't never heard of no Kilmer Building. And look at that thing, good gracious. Tartaria, right there. Look, you want to see Tartaria? Oh, you want to see Tartaria? What in the world? That ain't no building. That's an erector set. That's a Lego kit right there. That's what this is. That's a Lego kit. Wow. Wonder how they built a Lego kit that size. That's amazing. Tartarian lion, Tartarian lion, Tartarian lion, Tartarian lion, Tartarian lion, Tartarian lion. I'm getting tired of Tartarian line. Whoo, I'm wore out counting on them Tartarian lines. All over this sucker. Good gracious. That looks like a Phoenician wave. Got keystones. These look like they're scrubbed to me. Looks like they came in here and chiseled these off flat. That's just an opinion. Ooh, wait, look at the detail in this. I mean, this building is rocking with some stuff, man. Look at that. Woo-wee. Man. We don't have the intelligence to build this building. I'm just saying. I'm not, you know, saying that we can't do anything or can't build nothing, but, you know, the stuff we built, it just falls apart. And this is not something that's going to fall apart. I mean, look at the quality. We don't do quality. We don't know how. Ooh, look back here. Big old Antiquitech antenna with a big old dome. Okay, let's look, see what we got, y'all. Okay, man. Even these side buildings are here. Look at the detail on that. My goodness. That reminds me of like India right there. This building on the left. Man, got your pyramid here, got portals. This is some crap we added right here. See how it looks like shit? Well, that's how you know we did it. Anything looks like crap, like, you know, a phone pole that's crooked. See that phone pole? They didn't even put straight phone poles up at the time. Oh, we etched our name into it. Mm-hmm. Yep, and they probably scrubbed these cartouches. I think these represent the Taurus field. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I think this building was scrubbed good. I bet there was some juicy stuff on this building. Let's get down here. See what we got going on down here. Pavement light right there. Boom. Evidence of mud flood. Right there. See that? Man. Look at the size of that door. That is a good, oh gosh, how hot that, man, at least 12-foot door. That thing could be taller. I don't got nothing to go by. Let's see, this bike is about 4 feet. That could be a 15-foot door. That's a big, that's what you call one big-ass door right there. Man, that thing's big. Look at all that pavement light. Pavement light, pavement light, pavement light. Boom, boom, boom. You see that? Right there, I'm telling you, that right there is, that is the best evidence right there that tells you right there, that's a mud flood building. You see that? As soon as you see that, stamp it mud flood. Boom. Bada bing, bada boom. You're done. You can walk away. You can just, you know you've done your job. Okay, look at that mud flood windows down there. Look at that. See, these boys is trying to cover it up. We done called them in the act. You're busted. Look at that. Good gracious. We done called them in the act. These is actively covering up mud flood. They ain't getting away with it because we're on the job. We are on the scene investigating y'all ass. We're going to catch you and we're going to hang you up by the nearest doggone telephone pole, which is right here. And we're going to hang you out and upside down and shake out all your coins. Until you tell us that you know that this is a mud flood building. You don't have to tell us. We already know. You ain't gonna tell us nothing we don't know. We already know. All right. That right there, possibly, hard to say. That's either a crate for these wrought iron here, or it could be a crate for pavement light. I'm not sure. Not sure. I would say it's probably for the wrought iron. Man. All right. Let's move on. That is pretty cool. You guys, we know you're just being told what to do. You're just doing as you're told. We'll leave you alone, even though y'all know if something's going on. Okay. All right. Let's see what else we got here. Okay. This is Chicago Union Station. And let me tell you, people, Chicago is a mud flood city. Now, I'm telling you, it is. What they did was they went in and they made it a law. Okay. They gave you two choices. Your choice A was raise your building to the new street level that the city had decided. Okay. Choice B was they demolish your building and you lose it. That was your two choices. And you had to do this. It was your responsibility to raise your building. So Chicago is definitely a mud flood city. If anybody tells you Chicago was not mud flooded, don't know what they're talking about. Okay, right here we got 8-point asterisks. Okay. Kind of hard to see, but here it was pick one block out. Got your vertical, your horizontal, and your X. Okay? 8-point asterisks. That's my symbol for mud flood. Okay? It's everywhere. Seems to be very prominent in America. Seems to be kind of what I'm seeing is that America had, that was an American thing, or at least a North American thing from what I've researched so far, but I'm not convinced of it yet. We got pavement lights here all on the floor, just like Union Station in New York. If you've ever seen pictures of that, same thing. This was built by the same people long ago. This is old world building. Okay. We're just looking at this. Look at these beautiful lights. Those are cool. And they had iron. Okay. They had steel back then. We didn't invent that shit. They had it. Okay. That's something they act like they created, that we created. That's not true. Okay. Look at the size of this thing. That's incredible. Absolutely incredible. There's no reason to build something this big. Excuse me. There's, that's just next level. I don't know. That's amazing. Let's move on. Cleveland. Oh, 1905. Yes, I found this picture. This is the Central Armory, Cleveland, Ohio National Guard. This is also called Gray's Armory. Okay, now, I've done a lot of research on this area, on Cleveland, and this particular building is very interesting because today, this building does not look like this. Okay, it is like a third or a quarter of what was there originally, and this, I think, I've looked through my images to see, but I think that this image is the best image that shows the size of the building the best. Like, it, there's very few images of it, and I think this one shows the size of the sucker the best over any picture I've ever found. This thing is like straight Moorish. Got your eagle on sitting on the ball. Look at that. That's really interesting right there. That's some sort of antenna. And this is supposed to represent the Ohio National Guard. But that's, you know, who knows what that actually meant. I mean, this, the architecture here, this is supposed to be, you know, for the National Guard back in 18 whatever. Okay. This is when this thing was built. And here's another thing, and I haven't been able to, I did look at this to try to determine, but I could not figure it out. I have to take more research time. But the door that's there today looks a lot like this. But what's weird is the door today has steps coming down and the door is up. So I don't think this is the, I think that the today's part is over here or on the other side around this corner here. But it's really hard to tell. I think this might be on a different level in the front or something. I don't know, something weird about that. But this is a very good picture of this armory. And this sucker is just, it's a castle. I mean, thing is badass. You got all these Tickletech antennas. What we got up here? Look at that. Probably a mercury ball up there. Man. I bet that's some sort of tech right there. Those suckers right there. That thing is just beautiful in the construction. That's just amazing. And look at these windows here. We got mud flood windows, so that sucker goes down in the ground. So maybe this sucker is lower now. I don't know. That I'd have to do quite a bit of research on that. I don't know. That's amazing. Anyways, moving on. What else we got? We got Detroit, 1906. Hotels St. Clair, maybe? Randolph and Monroe Streets, completed in 1893, raised in the 1930s. Wow, so this sucker had a 43 year, 45 yearish lifespan. It was only worth 45 years to these people. 45 years. You're going to build something this expensive, this elaborate, this beautiful, and in 45 years, you're going to say, nah, piss shit. Blow it up. Piss shit, blow it up. Let's get it out of here. It ain't worth a damn. Now, you tell me what kind of fool thinks that ain't worth a damn. Now, this is weird. This is something I've never seen. Flagpoles, quote unquote, going out the side. So that's an Anticlotech flagpole. And look at this one. This one's kind of an angle. That is something new. You got you another antenna over here. And these antennas are going to the side. I have never seen that. That's interesting. Got your antennas up here. Man, 45 years, and they say this is not worth a damn. Got your diamond symbology here. I'd say this is probably Phoenician right here. I can't see that too good. It almost, I wonder if I could see it better over here. Sometimes you can't. No, it ain't showing it to me. I can't see this real good, but it kind of looks like a bullseye. And every time I see a bullseye, I think of the circumpunct. So, I don't know. That's 2 cents. I don't know what's worse. Hold on, stay on the same building. See that symbol a little bit better there. God, look at whoo, man, look at the brickwork there. Oh, that is just incredible. The intricacies of that design is just, that's just phenomenal. Got your laurel leaf there. That's symbology. Oh, got pavement light. What does that mean? I wonder what pavement lots mean. Oh, you mean there's stuff under the pavement lot? My goodness. Huh. I guess that's mud flood. Oh, we got it all the way around the block. Dang. Look at that. Right down the hole. Boom, down the hole. There's your mud flood. You want to see mud flood? I'll give you mud flood. See, people, I ain't here trying to explain what mud flood is. If you're here, you already know. I don't need to hold your hand. I'm just trying to help you see it quicker and better. That's all. Because the more you know, the little details, little stuff I can point out to you, maybe you can help others spot it too better. See these transom, these are prism glass. Anytime you see these, look down. Because the same companies that sold the prism glass, which are glass that shoots the light back into the building, sold the pavement lights. So anytime you see these, which most of them are covered up today, but A lot of the towns and cities are uncovering these to get the vintage look. So you're starting to see them more and more. But anytime you see these, look down because the same company sold them. Look at these people decked to the nines. That's incredible. This must be Boss Man Convention right here. That might be Boss Man right there. I don't know. He very suspicious of looking at like a boss man. I don't know. I always look for the boss man. You never know. Okay, we got the ladies hanging out with their big ass hats. Why are they always wearing hats? I mean, was it a shower thing because they couldn't wash their ass? Or was it, I mean, it can't be fashion. I mean, hats hot, you know? Why are you wearing hats all the time? Why are these, I mean, is the sun too much for them? Oh, we get to go over here too. That got pavement light on the other side of the street. Good gracious, it's everywhere. This place is bleak pavement lights. I mean, see, anytime, this is another thing. Anytime you see, you know, the headers like this on these buildings, see, there's your prism lights, your transom prism lights right there. Anytime you see fancy headers like that, okay, where they're rounded, they're decorative like that, that's old world. I mean, just that's just something that is from a very distant past. I can't see if they got pavement light over there. We got some trolleys here. Got some horses and carts. See, this is what they built these buildings with, supposedly. Yeah, they say they haul all the shit in with that little ass cart and build that. Kiss my ass. Y'all gone crazy, you believe that? There's a big old antenna. We've got some unidentified thing there. Man. See these right here, these headers, I mean, this, just, we don't build like that. No way. No. And I know we've always thought that we built this stuff. That's because, you know, they told us so. Yeah. See, one generation tells the next generation, tells the next generation, tells the next generation the same bullshit story, and we all believe the same bullshit lie. Well, it's time to stop believing the bullshit. Look at this. This is some kind of technology right here. That's not just decoration. That has a purpose, a technical purpose. So do these. It's a pyramid. And I find these interesting. It's like a pyramid without the top. I don't know what you call this specifically, but they're see this horseshit we had. See this piping back here? That's our horseshit. But see, this was here, and this is part of the system that was used to ventilate or in some way, shape, or form, keep the temperature, I think is the best way to say, of these buildings. They weren't chimneys, you didn't burn wood in them. That's why we had to retrofit them with inserts. Ceramic inserts and metal inserts, things like that. And see, all that's underground, all right there. That looks like a portal. Man. Dry goods. The word's always been weird to me. I don't know why. He had dry goods stores. I mean, I never seen a wet goods store. So why did they call it a dry food store? Chop suey. Huh. All right. Chop suey. Weird. Okay. Billiard room. Go play you some pool. Wow. That's a great picture. Cut rate. What? Is this? Hard to see. Almost like a 666, but I don't think it is. Removal sale. Okay. What are we removing? What the hell does that mean? Are they removing the building? Okay, I don't know. Wow. Okay, let's move on. What else we got? Manhattan circa 1906, Times Building, recently completed New York Times newspaper headquarters, now encased in electronic signage. The venue of New York's ball drop gave the former Longacre Square its current name. Okay. Wow. So this building, right? Okay. Okay, I see what it is. Times Square, we're used to looking from this direction back this way. And so the big old ball that drops is up on this sucker right here on the other side. But this thing's surrounded by all that horseshit signage that they got now. That is what it looks like in reality. Ooh, that's awesome. Here, let's look over here. What we got here? 23rd, after shopping lunch down, who cares? Metropole. That's interesting. Okay. We added the fire escapes. See these winders, these headers up here? Mm-hmm. Man, I can't see too good down there. Look at da-da-da. There you go. So there's your mud flood right there. So anytime you see these iron railings here, that means there's a mud flood behind it. That's what they put them up. They put them up there so people didn't fall into them. So basically, the Times Building in Times Square is a mud flutter. I did not know that. Now you do. I know and you know. Now that I know, you know. How about that? Well, nobody told me. Let's see. Wow. Look at that. Jeez. Good gracious. They hid that with a Coca-Cola sign. You son of bitches. Why would you do that? I mean, you gonna throw a doggone Nike label on this son of a bitch right here. You gone cuckoo. Whoever did that, whoever's idea it was to hang a damn ball and drop it off this son of a bitch and think that that damn ball looks better than this beautiful piece of architecture is a dumbass. I mean, straight dumbass. Good gracious, look at that. Cool. That thing is dope. I mean, seriously, talk about fire. That building's fire right there. That's pure fire. Good gracious. Let me get over here. You got your subway down here. So this is underground right here. Okay. Wow. I don't know what that building is, but that thing is cool. Whew, that's old world. Oh, we got a flag hanging off the Antiquitech. Oh, wow, that's just cool. Here's more subway right here. There's your Phoenician business there. You got your Taurus right there. That maybe, possibly, could be a lion. Maybe. I don't know. I can't prove it. Wow, okay. Make sure I missed nothing over here. Oh, what's this? Look at that thing. Good gracious. That's technology. It ain't just pretty, people. That's technology. Okay, let's move on. Let's see what else we got. New York, 1904, Hotel Martha, Washington. Hotel Martha, Washington. Well, that sounds stupid. Which building is it? Oh, it must be the big one. Okay. So we got an American flag hanging off the Antiquitech antenna. This thing's got, I would say these are lights. Rough guess, Antiquitech antenna. See, we would add this horseshit piping here because we can't. It's great. Look how they hid that. Oh my God. I mean, this stuff is just. Why would you do? Oh God, that's horrible. Oh gosh. This is our horseshit. This is the crap that we do. Look at that piping right there. We did that. That's the crap we do. That is our stuff. I mean, it's so obvious when you see our stuff compared to the awnings. That's our crap. We added that crap. Awnings are bullshit. Look at that old ass ivy there. How long's that been there? Woo! Hello, mud flood. Anybody want to come here for mud flood? Well, there you go. You can have some mud flood. I'll give it to you. I don't mind. I'll give you all the motherfucker I got. Here you go. You can have it. It's all yours. Good grief. Good grief. And why are you going to build this big old three-story building, quote unquote, it's actually at least a four-story building, and then put bars on the windows because you put the windows below ground level? It's stupid. That just doesn't even make any sense at all. Nope. There's, see, going down in the hole. Boom. Winter's in the hole. Winter's in the hole, boys. Okay. Okay. Oh, and girls. Don't forget the girls. Let's see. Here we go. Good grief. I mean, they gonna build this big ass building with this little ass cart. That's how they say they did it. That's what we are told, people. They told us they built big ass buildings with little ass carts and horses and hammers. I'm done believing it. Got your Florida Lee, it looks like. Wow. Amazing. Look at these lights. That's crazy. Some more symbology there. I can't see what it is. Goodness gracious. Okay, let's move on. Wow. Okay. A 1905 Chicago State Street looking towards Adams. Okay. Let's get down here. Oh, we got our big ass hats. Boy, he is just going somewhere. He knows where he's going. He's got a date. That's where he's going. He's on a date. He's going to a date. And this fella trying to make him a buck. Oh, and there's a pavement light. I guess I should have started there. Oh, wow. Okay, got your coal hole cover here. I know it's big, but that is a coal hole cover. Okay. Let's see. Ice cream soda, 10 cents. Everybody's decked to the nine. Got our boater hats. Okay. Tailoring on credit. Credit. Credit, credit, credit. Easy payments. Okay. Man, a lot of credit signs. Huh. Wow. Dentist. I can't read that sign. Let's go up here, see what's going on up here. Huh. That building's kind of odd. Almost like it's got a modern, more modern window installed or something. I don't know. That's odd. Got portals up here. What in the world? Odd area. Ooh, what we got here? Rubies? No, I can't read it. Huh. It's like Florida Lees. That's pavement light right there. It's hard to tell, but that's what that is. Oh, what is that? 8-point asterisk. Right there. Dang, I ain't even found that one yet. Okay, I'm going to have to put that one in my collection. Okay. All right. Dang, that thing is everywhere. Gosh. Let's see. Got your cow scoop on the front. Man. Wow, that's crazy. Oh, goodness gracious. I get just breathtaked. I mean, good grief. The world, I mean, it's dumbfounding to imagine, you know, in 1900-ish that they had this much going on architecturally. I mean, I thought they were primitive people, man. They were simple. There's technology there. Wow, there's technology. You got antenna. Big old dome. That's all technology. That is amazing. Wow. I wish I could see that better. It's like a big statue. So cool. Okay. Moving on. Kingston, Point Park, Kingston, New York, on the Hudson River. Okay. Let's just see what these people are up to. Okay. People deck to the nines to go to a little park on the Hudson River. Central Hudson. I think these boats are old world too. Got your antennas up there. Oh, there's your 8-point asterisk. There it is again. It's everywhere. People just chilling by the river here, just hanging out. What you got there? Big old church looks like. Wow. I mean, what in the world is this thing? You know, gazebos, there's something about them. They were some sort of technology. I'm not sure what they were for, but what is that? Any ideas? It reminds me of like a transformer, you know, in an electrical power station. I don't That thing is weird. Okay. Utah, circa 1900, Salt Air Pavilion, Great Salt Lake City. So this sucker is out on the middle of the Great Salt Lake. Because, well, this is the kind of thing that you need in the middle of a lake for shindigs. I mean, why would you need this out in the middle of a lake? There's John Levy symbol. I don't know. This is John Levy territory now. He's out there somewhere. Look at these domes. I mean, that's just technology, people. I'm sorry. You got to realize that that's technology. Look at that thing. What is that? I mean, seriously. That is straight up technology. That's not just decoration. And this is something that I'm starting to think about is that if you'll notice that this is a very good example of this. This thing's made of wood, okay? This is obviously old world. And I think a lot of times, most of the time, and I'm guilty of this also, is that we always focus on the stone and the brickwork. Well, what about all the wood? You know, all a lot of the most of the mansions and the or at least let me back up. A lot of the mansions and a lot of the homes were built out of wood. Okay, the old world did use wood. You know, we tend to forget that there's a lot of wood structures. And I think more needs to be done in the research of that because, you know, anybody that's in the construction trade or has done anything, any kind of work on older homes or has worked anywhere that has old wood in it, you know that the old wood is a much different monkey than what we use today. That the old wood is not anywhere close, it's not remotely close to the wood you go down to Home Depot or Lowe's and buy today. It's not the same wood at all. It's stronger, it's heavier, it's cut straight. There's no it's not smooth edges. There's square edges. A 2x4 is actually 2 inches by 4 inches instead of being 1.5 inches by 3.5 inches. It's an actual 2x4, which is why they call it a 2x4 today. Because a 2x4 used to be a 2x4. A 2x6 was a 2x6, not a 1.5x5.5. Okay. My point is that old lumber, okay, I always thought that old lumber was just, back in the day when they didn't, sand down the edges and make it smooth, which is true to an extent. But what if that wood is not even from our time? What if that wood is much older? What if that wood is from the old world? What if that is evidence for the old world? Just something I've been thinking about. Maybe y'all can think about it too and let me know what you think in the comments. I love the comments. Make some comments. Speak your mind. Tell people your ideas. I want to hear them. Other people want to hear them. We need to communicate in this community. We need to voice our opinions and ideas and work this thing out together. Anyways, moving on. Oh, this was interesting. Pittsburgh Water Heater Company, in Washington, D.C., 1920. And what I thought was interesting about this is people have been talking recently about the radium heaters, and this is a radium water heater, it seems to appear, where you would throw some radium in here and it would heat up. Highly efficient, some in the world on tabloid color. The effect is instantaneous immediately after lighting. Instantaneous. I'm not sure if that's instantaneously. Basically, the effect. Basically, what they're saying here is basically you light the sucker and it. You're getting hot water. Pure radiant heat like sunshine in your home. So this sucker, you would put radium in there and it would create heat. I think that's very interesting. That needs to be flushed out more. Very interesting. What we got over here? Okay, that looks like a squeegee thingy for doing laundry, maybe. That looks like a washing machine. Is that a washing machine? I don't know. Somebody tell me what you think it is. National Mazda lamps. The way to better light. An old iron. Automatic gas water heater. Wow. Look at that. That's a water heater. Holy crap. Holy crap, Batman. Hunt for radiant heat. Chase the chills with a radiant fire and save coal. Various sizes and finishes makes any fireplace attractive distributors for Pittsburgh automatic hot water heaters. What is that thing? Is that a, that must be a heater. Man, I don't even know. This is some like old world space tech right here. I don't, what the hell is going on here? I don't know. Y'all gonna tell me what this is. This is above my pay grade. What it got down in the store? Let's see if we can see back here. Nope, can't see it. All right. Wow, that's crazy time. Okay, Washington, D.C., 1900, house in which Abraham Lincoln died in, the row house at 516 10th Street Northwest, where President Abraham Lincoln died on April 15th, 1865, after being shot across the street at Ford's Theater. And the reason I wanted to show this is because, one, Lincoln died in a mud flutter, which I think is just amazing. See, mud flutter. Lincoln died in a mud flutter. Got some symbology here. And with a flat earth asterisk on the front door. That just cracked me up when I saw that. Okay, guys. So, a little American history for you there. Okay, let's go look at a catalog. Woo! So here we go. We got daylighting catalog, prism transoms, sheet prism glass, diffusing tile, sidewalk lights, floor lights, skylights, sidewalk doors, and their accessories. Catalog number 21, American Three-Way Lux for Prism Company. Let's see what these suckers got. Consolidation, blah blah blah. Prismatic transom lights. Da-da-da-da. American Three-Way Prism Company, American Lux for Prism Company. I guess they're merging. I guess they're just announcing that. Okay. Interesting. And they're showing here some of their jobs that they've done. Not very good pictures. But you see, these are transoms here. These prism lights here, those are prism lights, and they go in the transoms. And what they do is, if you're inside the store looking to the out, you're in the back of the store looking to the out back front of the store. This is what it would look like. It would look really bright. And the idea is to get the light to go back into the store. Here's another photograph right here. And you're seeing that brightness on the light. That's from these windows right here, shining the light. What happens is the light comes in from above and it hits these and it shoots it into the building. So this is something we added to compensate for the lack of windows, and not having electricity, and to save on not having to burn gas, and gas was very hot, especially during the summer. So that's what that's about. Value and cost of daylight compared with artificial illumination. So this gives you some information on that. And I highly suggest you read this stuff if you're interested in. I'm not going to read it to you. You learn more if you read it. I'm just giving it to you and showing it to you and pointing it out to you. And maybe talking about a little bit here, a little bit there. These little boxes in the middle, what that is they had a way of opening the middle or certain sections of it in order to allow in air, because they didn't have any air. They didn't have windows like we have now where you can just open the windows. So this is how they would get air in to get ventilation. Of course, I don't think they work real well, but it gives you an idea how the light hits the prismatic glass and then shoots back into the building. Here's another example. This is a really good example of how this works. And this is the theory, is it comes out, hits the prism, and then shoots to the, inside. That's what's on the front of those transoms right there. That's a prismatic glass. And if you find these today, the older ones, if they were left in the transoms and were exposed to light for a certain period of time, they turned purple because of an element in the glass. And so the purple ones are actually very valuable now. So if you see these, somebody getting rid of these, get them, because they're valuable. Same with, and now the pavement lights, now those things are gold. You see somebody throwing away some of those, get those things. But don't try to take them out of the frames. They have to be taken out of the frames very carefully, because they're surrounded by concrete. There's ways to do it, but you have to be very, very careful. But those are very expensive. Those are highly valuable. They're I would definitely hold on to those. Here's some a lot of these some of these Luxfers were supposedly designed by Frank Lloyd Wright, which is probably bullshit, but that's the going story. That's the official story. Here's one of those transom windows, and this would be able to turn up and allow in light. This is called the teardrop version here. Let's see. See these things right here, they open up, and that's what gave you ventilation. This is before fans, people. They had no fans. It was a different time. This one right here, it's kind of hard to see, but this whole frame right here is nothing but prismatic glass, and they would raise and lower this as the light would change, the sunlight would change. They could turn it up and down to get the light to go where they wanted. So that's interesting. They had all kinds of different gizmos and creations to move that light around. This isn't light in a factory. Design prisms. Okay. All right. Move on down. Let's go on down. Ooh, I like pavement light. Okay. Got pavement light here. Look at that. That's a nice mud flood right there. Hiding that mud flood. There's your pavement light. Okay. But gee, I'm gonna like as always, I'm gonna have the pictures in this video and the catalogs for this video in the description so you can look at the stuff yourself and do your own thinking. That's a really good one right there. Wow. So much of this stuff is gone now. They've destroyed it. I mean, these pictures were taken back when this stuff was new, or very young. Okay. Let's see. It's all standard issue stuff. They just you can learn a lot about this stuff if you really want to learn about it. These catalogs are very, very helpful to learn. Here's them installing pavement light. So that's the installation picture. I need to copy that sucker. Let me copy that. Okay. All right, I want to copy that. Put that in my collection. These are prefabbed slabs of pavement lights, and what you would do is you would frame it in with your I-beams and then slap this down. It's a way of making it quicker. That would be a prefab piece right there. These are probably prefab too. Look at that sucker. Cool. Man. That's massive. That is all underground. Every bit of that. There is a big cavern underneath that thing. Daggone. Round glass reinforced concrete at world's busiest corner, State and Madison Streets in Chicago. Wow, that's incredible. Oh man, there's more Chicago. They had all kinds of things they could do with this stuff. It's mostly gone now, though, because the turned purple and it wasn't as strong as they thought it would be, and rain weather destroyed it. And man, I bet you it was a heck of a thing to see when that was all around the place. That coal hole covers. Prism glass inserts. These are just glass inserts for sidewalk lights. This kind of shows you how some of this stuff goes together. Let's see. Oh, pretty. Okay, that's about it for that catalog. All right, let's go look at another catalog. Okay, we'll look at glass for every industry. Harris Turner Glass Company, Philadelphia, PA. Okay. Let's see. Making the sheet glass, pane glass. That's a cool picture. Let's see. What do we got here? Glass for every industry. Lighthouse quality. Okay. Let's see. There's our factory. Another factory. And another factory. Blah 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 blah. You can read this for yourself. Lighthouse, da, 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 da. Published in four languages. Lighthouse quality. Purpose is to assure customers the grading of the glass is guaranteed as represented. Okay, whatever. They did it. They like their lighthouses, don't they? Wait. Lighthouses were somehow. Ooh, that's a cool photo. Let me make that a little smaller. Let's see. Wow, large sheet lighthouse quality polished plate glass requiring eight men to handle. That's a big sucker. So they had to make these big plate glasses to close to put in the windows of those big buildings that storefronts that we stole. So yeah. Mixing the ingredients from which glass is produced. Okay. Ovens for the molten glass. Okay, pouring the molten glass. These are cool pictures. A lot of people are into glass making and stuff. So these big tables with the glass is poured onto, and then they cut it on here, or at least I think this is where it dries. They pour it out on this big round doohickey here. That's pretty cool. This was a very the secrets of glass trade are well kept. They didn't want a lot of people knowing how this was done. I don't know why, but I guess some houses with their glass in it or something. What else we got here? These are examples of where you can, how you can use their glass. Blah blah blah. Okay. All right. If you find this stuff interesting, then go and look further. That's a pretty cool picture. Old stores are very interesting. We just don't make the cabinetry and the display cases. We didn't make all that. That's something that we stole. That those were in the buildings when we stole them. I think we kept all this stuff. Look, I mean, just look at the quality. You're telling me that they needed and could and did make this quality of cabinetry in 1850, 1860, 1870? I mean, come on. It's not true. And it's everywhere. It's not like it's one store or like a few places or a lot. It's every store had this quality. We stole this stuff. I mean, you want to know where the old world furniture is? It's right in front of you. That's old world furniture, people. We didn't build that either. We stole that. That's stolen furniture. I know it's store shelves and stuff, but that's furniture. Some things they could figure out how to use, and other things they couldn't. Like you can't fit, a 6 foot man in a chair that's designed for a 12 foot man. It just doesn't work. But a display case now, well, hell, anybody can appreciate a big ass display case. I mean, look at these things. That is incredible. You know how hard it is to make these things? Jeez. Glass displays. Interesting contraption. We'll get you fishies. Okay. Electric coach. What, a horse trolley? Huh. Not too bad. That's a cool picture. I like that. Don't. Got a broken window. Oh, that's cool. Blah, blah, blah. Let's move it on down. Making the glass. Making mo glass. Making mo glass. This is just the process here. Oh, that's cool. Look at that thing. Wow. Well, I think I'd want to work with glass. Imagine how many times you get cut. I don't know. Look at that. Gosh. That's incredible. Whoa. Man. You think we have fancy stuff now? No. We got crap now. Our world's crap. That's cool looking. Man. Well, I don't think I'd want that job. No, sir. What the heck is that thing? What a blowing glass by machine processors. Cylinders shown here are approximately 40 feet long. That's a 40-foot long cylinder? All right. Okay. Okay. Damn, look at that thing. Lowering cylinder after completion of blowing. What the hell do you use that for? What the heck? Look at that thing. What do you need glass tubes for? It looks like they're cutting them here. What are these, fish tanks? What are these things? What in the world is this fool doing? Flattening the split cylinder. Wait, go back up. Cylinder entered in a flattening oven after being cut and split. Huh. Weird. I don't know. Strange. There it is again. La-di-da-di-da. X-ray glass, okay. Oh, looks like cheap glass. Ba, 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 ba. There's some old world architecture. Case you ain't never seen that out before. That's cool. There's some more old world architecture. Huh. Get you some wire in your glass. Wow. Well, build your whole building out of glass. This is how it goes together. Blueprints for putting glass together. Crazy stuff. I'm moving on down. There's 173 pages. That's pretty cool. Bah, bah, bah. Get some transoms here. Look at that pavement light right there. Bum, bum, bum. Oh. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Huh. It's a neat picture. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Very, very interesting. All these little parts and pieces are how this world was built and fixed and covered up. That's what's nice about these catalogs is they show you some of this piece by piece, you know, the little Lego pieces that go into making this world. That there's your 8-point asterisk right there. Right there. It's everywhere. Everywhere. Okay, he's showing how it goes together, blah blah blah. That's not too interesting. Unless you like that sort of And if you do, go to the back and look at it. Like I said, all these will be in the description. Love these old storefronts. They're so incredible. There's their 8-point asterisk right there. I think. Yeah, it's right there. Yep, I see it all over the place. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Okay. A lot of glass in the old world. Looks like pavement light down there. Well, we're about to get through here. Some tools for cutting the glass. Cut you some circles in there. See, this is back before Lowe's, Home Depot. You know, you had your hardware store, but, you know, for. You know, stuff like this, I mean, you had to order it. Different world. There's your 8-point asterisk right there. Right there. Yep. There it is again. Right here. Okay. You notice how the asterisk part is closer in to the center. These ones right here are off the center. That's 8-point asterisks. Same with this one. There's one, two. That is not one. And I don't know about that one. I don't know if I could give that one up and that one. So that's three. Anyways, 8-point asterisks give you some stained glass type things. Well, okay, that's the end. All right, I sure appreciate your time. Links are in the description, and I will check you later. This Beaks out. Now, reflect as I realize it's all I am.
woof again! Say woof again!
I've got one that can see.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later!